Patanjali was about 3,000 years before, 1,500 years before Christ. And he was or is known as a father of psychology. He researched the psychic problems of the human, very detailed. What is the body? What is the emotion? What is the mind? What is intellect? What is intelligence? What is the consciousness and energy, and energy and consciousness? What is the soul? And what is Atma? And which kind of postures or techniques can help them to realize? If someone have a headache, where is the cause? Which gland, which organs of the body, what needs, and how the mind and body and emotion, intellect, consciousness and intelligence, they are coordinating each other. So great saints brought the sense of this life and the way to the origin, back to the God. When the Patanjali used to speak to his disciples, disciples were sitting there, that's called Upanishad. Upanishad, the word Upanishad means, up means near. Shad means the disciple. The disciple sits near the master and listens to the wisdom. You can say gospel or dialogue. But dialogue is different. Dialogue is where you ask the questions and meanings and this, not that's not correct, but this is not like this. When the Patanjali in forest, in his hut, the rishis means the hermitis, living in the forest, small hut and beautiful. It is said, the tigers, the lions, the deers, cows, the goats, the peacock birds and other birds, all came and sat near him listening. They were worried. The tiger is sitting there and goat is also sitting there. Can you imagine? But it can be. If there is a love, then it can be. And Patanjali is saying in his first writing, he's saying to his disciples, you know, masters were not that who said, please come and do it. No, please. Why? Come or go. It's your decision. Master is like a lake. If you are thirsty, come and drink. And if you are thirsty and you don't drink, go. Is your problem? Thirsty came, thirsty go. So we have to make a step towards that one which is there. So Patanjali says, first, Atha Yoganushasanam. My dear devotees, yoga begins with the discipline. If you have no discipline in your life, you can't be successful in anything. key to the success is a self-discipline. 98% of our problems, physical, mental, social, in relations with partners, friends, animals, forest, country, and business, is from our side that we have no discipline in this. And so masters or yoga teacher, who is really a teacher, you know. And to become a yoga teacher, you have to practice at least 90 years to learn. After 90 years, you are a yoga teacher. Otherwise, we are disciple. People ask me, Swamiji, are you guru? I say, no, I am disciple. On the day when I will say, yes, I am guru, then you can say, it's not a guru, but it's a kangaroo, jumping here and there. Therefore, a great person, wise man said, bada badai nahi kare. The great one never speaks great things about himself. Bada ne bole bol. He or she will never prize itself. There was a great poet, Rahim Das. And Rahim Das said, when does a diamond speaks and call the customers, hey, I am diamond and my value is $1 million. Does diamond speak this? No. We say, wow, it's a diamond. And others said, yes, it is. The price is so and so much. Diamond keeps silent because he knows it is others' job to give value, not my job. Similarly, a master, a guru, a perfect person will not say that I am guru. And when it begins to say, yes, I am a guru, then it means he's a self-made one, that is a blind street. And we don't want to enter the blind street. No? When we go even walking to the blind street, and other side behind coming some Doberman, angry one, then we don't have the way to run away from other direction because it's blind. We have to turn back and there's a Doberman standing. Which situation we have. Therefore, always we surrender towards the Satguru Dev. Our spiritualness, that water will become Ganges, holy Ganges water, which will enter into the Ganges. And that water will not be called as Ganges water if it goes out in the canalizations. So, join a living master lineage with background the holy divine lineages. So, as long as we are here, we are disciple. We are the practitioners and we are the servant of all humans and all creatures. My master, Holy Guruji, what we call, Swami Madhavananji, we call Hindu Dharma Samrat. When he came somewhere to speak, then he said in his speech, I am thankful to God and Mahaprabhuji that I could serve you with my limited knowledge. These are my words which I am telling you and explaining is my service to you. Not that I am preaching and saying do this and this. No. It is service. Humbleness. Holy Guruji said, be humble like a tree. When the fruits rise, then branches of the tree bends down that you can get it easily. So when the wise man, a yogi, gets such a knowledge, then becomes humble. No anger, no jealous. You are like a light. No darkness can come to this light. As long as this light is burning, shining, no darkness can come.